Welcome all to the lecture series of function of complex variable. In the previous lecture, actually, I have discussed what is the complex valued function and how we can draw the graph of a complex valued function in the form of the MATLAB code. As well as I have discussed what do you mean by the multi-valued function and single valued function. So in this lecture, I am going to discuss the limit of a complex valued function, because limit of a function is very much important for us to evaluate the approximated value of a function at a particular point where the functional value is not directly defined. So you know that this is the main intention to find out the limit of a function. So for a complex valued function fz, if it is not defined at a particular point z0 directly, that means we won't be able to find out the value of fz by putting the value of z as z0, then we need to find out the limit at the point z0. So what is the formal definition of the limit? So the function fz is said to tend to the limit w0 whenever z tends to z0 if for any epsilon there corresponds a value, positive value delta, that depends on epsilon, such that the functional value minus the limiting value of the function, the mod of this is less than equals to the predefined positive epsilon whenever the values of the independent variable z from the point z0 varies in the region, the difference of that value is varying in the region from 0 to delta, where the delta depends on epsilon. So here z is x plus iy, z0 is x0 plus iy0, because all are complex value. So in the complex value, we need to define some real part as well as some imaginary part. So fz equals to w, that is the functional value, that is u plus iv, and w0 equals to u0 plus iv0. So this is the formal definition. Now I want to illustrate this definition with the help of this given graph. So this is xy plane, that means we are identifying the independent variable z0 and z here, that means the x and y axis, the Argand plane. In that Argand plane, x represents the real axis and y represents the imaginary axis. So each and every value of z is mapped to w by virtue of the function w equals to fz, where fz is nothing but w. So in the case of the domain fz or the range fz, we are mapping z to w. So in w, actually we have taken the real axis as u and imaginary axis as v. So what does it mean? So around z0, we are taking a neighborhood whose radius is delta. Then we are varying the value of z in that neighborhood around z0. Then we will try to study where the functional values go, because we know that each and every z will be mapped to some w by virtue of the function w equals to fz. So if we can observe that whenever we are varying the value of z in a neighborhood around z0 with radius delta, we will find that there is a predefined epsilon. The value of delta depends on that epsilon in such a way that whenever we are varying the value of z inside that neighborhood, then the value of w will be varying inside the neighborhood of w0 with radius epsilon. That means we are varying the values of z here. Then we will find that for a predefined epsilon, the values of w will also vary in that particular neighborhood, and the values will be gradually tending towards w0 whenever we will take the values of z towards z0. That means more we will take the values of z nearer to z0, we will find that by virtue of that mapping, the values of fz will gradually move towards w0. So if it happens for a predefined epsilon and we can provide a value of delta which depends on the value of epsilon in such a way that the values of z whenever is approaching towards z0, the values of w is approaching towards w0, then we say that limit exists. If this doesn't happen, then we'll say that the limit doesn't exist for that particular function at the given point z0. Then I am going to define some properties of limit. So already you have studied whenever we have studied the real function. So same cases will exist for the limit of complex valued function. So if the limit of a function exists, then it will be unique. Then what is the second property? So if the limit of fz and gz exist separately, then the limit z tends to z0 fz plus gz will be same as the sum of the limits of fz and gz individual. Then if we know that limit of fz and gz exists separately, then limit z tends to z0 fz into gz will be nothing but the limit of fz at the point z0 into limit of gz at the point z0. Now limit z tends to z0 fz by gz will be same as limit z tends to z0 fz by limit z tends to z0 gz provided the limit z tends to z0 gz is not equals to 0. So that means if we know the limit of two functions separately, then the sum of the limit of the function, the product, the limit of the product of the function and limit of the quotient of the functions will be defined and will be defined in that way. Then we'll discuss one important theorem whenever we'll discuss the limit of a complex valued function. So what is this theorem? So you know that we can treat the complex valued function as a function of two variables, because here the independent variable is z. So in z there are two variables, x and y. One is the real part, another is the imaginary part. So we can identify fz as the function of two variable x and y. So in the case of fz, there are also the real part of fz and imaginary part of fz. So both the real part of fz and imaginary part of fz will be the functions of x and y separately. Now uxy, that is the real part of fz, is nothing but the function of two variable x and y. Similarly, the imaginary part of fz, that is v, is nothing but the function of two variables x and y. So in the previous semesters we have studied that we can find out the limit of functions of two variables separately. Now the limit of fz at the point z0 will exist if the limit of uxy at the point x0, y0, because z0 we can write down in the form of the order pair x0, y0. If the limit of uxy at the point x0, y0 and limit of the point vxy at the point x0, y0 exist separately. Moreover, the limit z tends to z0, uxy equals to u0, and if limit xy tends to x0, y0, vxy equals to v0, then the limit of fz at the point z0 will be same as u0 plus iv0, that means w0. That means if the limit of the real part of the functional value and imaginary part of the functional value exist separately at the point z0, then the overall limit of fz will exist, and that will be the sum of the limits of that two real and imaginary part. So this is an important theorem. Whenever we'll try to find out the limit of a complex valued function, we often use this theorem. So in the next lecture, actually I'll discuss how we can use this property in order to find the limit of a function, and in which cases we can say that the limit of a complex valued function doesn't exist. So in this lecture, so far we have studied what do we mean by the limit of a function, and graphically we have tried to identify how can we verify from graph that the limit exists for a particular function. Then I have studied actually what are the different properties of the limit of a complex valued function. Moreover, we have studied an important theorem where we have studied if the limit of the real part of the functional value and imaginary part of the functional value exist separately, then the overall functional value as a limit at that particular point, and that will be the sum of the limit of the real part and imaginary part. So thank you all for watching this lecture.